Welcome to the chat room there, Dan Long. And Zaza as well. Who else have we got? So, Andreas says for Martinez again. Kyle says not Borna. Poor Borna. Anyone would almost say that he's, So, who else? Anyone else want to say anything exciting? Apart from Borna getting old. Borna getting old, what is he now actually legal to drink? In at least one country in the world. I do find sometimes that I'm approaching the tender age of 28 this weekend. Which is going to be so fantastic. I'm so getting drunk. I've got to decide exactly where I'm going, actually, because my wife goes to me, oh, we need to find out somewhere where we can actually go. And I've never been go-karting, so I'm really trying to sweeten up the whole, can we please go go-kartings? Not that I think I'd actually be very fast, because obviously my weight counts. So, unless I can throw my boobs out each side like a ballast to get round to the corners a little bit quicker, I don't know if I'd really work. The only time I've ever been kind of half go-karting once was at Southend on Sea. They've got like this little dodgy Peter Pan Adventureland. I think it's turned into something a little bit better now. But they used to have this little dodgy go-kart track around there. I'll never forget being humiliated when this fat, obese, like 50-year-old gran got in and beat me around the track. I was like, I'm not going in one ever again. And so began my sim racing career. Beat the dodgy granny. Simon, what are you drinking in the UK? Sadly, Coke. Oh, it's not got JD in it. Or vodka. Oh. Aid Randall says, Lords 1, Paladins 0. Bom, 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 bom. Where's the alcohol gone? Well, that was... I've not been shopping yet. It's only Monday. Oh dear, has been, maybe. I do like it when people try and pop into a chat room and be a little bit boring for things, because I don't know, trying to be rude with the word anus doesn't really work, does it? Because it's a playful word, the kind of thing you'd use with the word trifle. Or maybe blancmange. Anal cavity? That sounds like I've gone to a dentist, Kyle. Anyway, on with the race, as we go. Right. Welcome, Woody, as well. I see an ongoing trend with some of these names in this chat room. So, we're off for race two, of course. We're starting on the formation lap. Sidnovus leads us round again after winning last time. Emmanuel Gaczela is second for Storm Racing once again. Borna Stoljarek third for Torrent Motorsport IB Porsche. I'm not doing a Legard start, no. Reino Muru fourth for Storm Racing. Fifth is Martin Palm for Torrent Motorsport IB Porsche. Sixth, Randy Muru in the courtesy car. I don't actually quite like the livery in that courtesy car. There's something very Tesco value about it. Seventh, Adrian McNaughton for Storm Racing Team. But in a good way, in a good way. Eighth, Mark Jones. Oh dear. No, I do like it actually, to be fair. Mark Jones for Adura Racing. Ninth, Aoife Bass for Storm Racing, and 10th, George Talbot in the 05 Motorsports car. 11th, Paul Joseph for Union Motorsports International. Where's Ryan Walker? 12th, John Gibbons for Psycho Racing. Get that Scott in here now. 13th, Mark McNaughton as an independent. 14th, Barry Ward. PR Rockstar. Oh my god. I have got Jones Tourette, so that's not even good. Ooh, as long as I don't go to work. Oh god! Oh, Jones! 15th, Aid Randall for English Racing Knight Lords. 16th, Mike Ward for English Racing Knight Paladins as they continue their battle. Paul Huggett, 17th, PPR Rockstar. 18th, Stuart Fleming for Team Core. 19th, Ilja Bregalo, Torrent Motorsport Mobile. 20th, Mark Gravitt. 21st, Tim Spur. 22nd, Tom Ely for the Nocturne team, rounding off the grid as he gets himself in plate. Yeah, there are a lot of fire cars at the back, to be fair. So, let's see. 16 laps of high octane action is off again, and we are away. Sidnova's not off to the perfect start this time around. Gaxella goes to cover the line straight away because someone's straight up onto the grass. Now's Martin Palm, who's off to a stinking start up into third position, past Bolyarik and Muru as they come diving down, but he's run out quite wide and smacks the barrier on the exit, and that's not going to help him at all. Spoliarik somehow able not able to get round. Barry Ward and Paul Joseph there have just collected each other towards the back, but everyone's staying in the right line. Mark Gravitt's down to last, so he's obviously been bundled out somewhere along the line, but everyone's through and going. Is everyone making it round the corners? It looks like it. Mark McNaughton way out wide, but somehow able to hold it as Ilja Bregalo bounces through into 14th position. Around he goes, and he's swiggling round and off. Ilja Bregalo once again in the centre of attention, going for an absolute disaster. Somehow everyone getting around Mark McNaughton, dropping down the order two, and that's because Stuart Fleming is trying to scrabble his Durex across the whole track. Someone's off. That is... Oh ho ho, McNaughton in trouble. The back of the field is absolutely clogged up. This is like some kind of dodgy Mario Plumber problem as they come round these last couple of corners. It's just some of the slower cars are holding up some of the faster ones. Up front, everything kind of looking nice and hunky diddly, but towards the back of the field, it's absolutely nuts. The Stuart Fleming there is about to be passed by quite a few people. That's Tom Ely into the pits straight away as Bricarlo once versus Stuart Fleming side by side into turn 1 and 2. That's not going to work. Somehow there Fleming manages to back out of it. Bricarlo to 16, spurs through as well. Mike Ward is off for English Racing Knights Paladins, and let's see what happened there. He'd lost it all on his own, actually. He just clips the barrier, the curb in the middle. Tom Ely out with an engine failure. Who's that we're oohing about? That is Tom Ely. And the Adur car of... Who is that out? Mark Gravitt. Somehow still going in 15th position, but everything going off left, right and centre as they negotiate Stuart Fleming. Tim Spurs, the next one that needs to get round them all. Up front, we have got a little train going on behind Emmanuel Gaxella, but everyone being relatively well behaved, to be fair. although, the Muru brothers are quite close to each other for 5 and 6 as they come round. No, everyone's not too bad. Let's swing up back down. Oh, Tim Spurs now in 17th position, side by side with Stuart Fleming down the home straight, and he is through before we even get to the kink of turns 1 and 2. And up he goes, Stuart Fleming, now not cock blocking everyone as he goes back down the field. As what is George off to? Is he off the track? Oh, Mr. Talbot. Just hearing in my little camera ears that George said he wasn't prepared for this race, I would say not half, son, because this is a little bit of a dodge going on for you, Mr. George Pudge. Sidnova still leading by 1.3 seconds. Bolyarek all over the back of Gaxella, though, as they're pushing each other out of the final corner. Bolyarek, I think, could quite fancy a nose at Gaxella. Neither of these two know the answer to backing off. And look at Gaxella there onto the grass to try and defend the position. Bolyarek go round the outside. They have plenty of history. You could almost say it's the Bible as things continue to go on. As Bolyarek, don't spag ball it, as you're almost into the barriers there, as he's running out wide, as he just, oh dearie me, not good. Let's pop on board with the feisty Borna himself. Now you can see you've got a face full of Emmanuel's anal varieties as round into this tight hairpin, and that's always deceiving, some of these camera shots that I'm watching, because it just looks like they're about to overtake each other and they're not really. But he's so up far behind, I think he could have a look at the end of this corner. He's fancying a nose through, very very slidey. Gaxella's going to be in a bit of trouble, but Borna once again straight onto the back of him as they come over the straight. All carnage going on behind. I can see changes of positions, but it's going to see what's happening with this down into turns 1 and 2. And Gaxella once again keeping the racing line, keeping it nice and sweet. Everyone continues on. Further down the field, John Gibbons had just passed Ilja Brocato for 12th and 13th positions as they both go round Paul Joseph in the Union Motorsport car, so that's interesting. As all kinds of problems going on back up the front. Borna. So let's see what he's going to do. Is he going to pull out? Is he going to fancy a nose back into the hairpin? Side by side they go again, and he is through up into second position. Good stuff by him. Mark Jones has just binned it for Regia Racing off the screen as well, as they continue side by side, and Gaxella has got the position back because he's got a whole body length in front of him. And if he can cut off Bolyarek, indeed he does. Fantastic driving there back from Gaxella, and good respectful driving there by Borna Bolyarek. Not often you hear those words always said about these two, because I think they're going to start flinging food at each other. As I said before, if there was a plate of food in front of these drivers, they would be covered in it in some kind of dirty, filthy thing that you'd see on a pay-per-view channel. As through goes Gaxella onto the grass, and that's not going to stop anywhere. Off goes Gaxella, and through up into second position goes Bolyarek. Palms into third as Gaxella tries to recover and get back in front onto the podium position, but Martin Palm is slinkier than a slinky on a slinky day. And up into third position he goes. Look at Reinu Muru there, as Kyle says that it's Kyle says Godzilla doesn't disappoint. There's a good name for him, actually, to be fair. Loving that. Who's that off the track? Oh, it's Barry Ward down into 10th position, I think, was off. Or is it Ehab Abbas, because George Talbot suddenly found himself in 8th position. There's no way in hell he should really be there with all of the dramas that he's been having. But yes, we've lost Mark Jones. He's gone off the track somewhere and crashed out. Mark Gravett is facing the wrong way in 17th position for Agira Racing. He's just rejoining back in behind. I think that's Mike Ward's gone up into 17th position. But yeah, that I think Mark Gravett is parking. So yeah, he's out. Stuart Fleming goes up into 18th. Paul Huggett will go up into 19th once he's caught him too. Indeed he has now. So we're down to just 19 runners and riders left on track. Sidnova still leads from Bolyarek, Palm, TM Motorsport 1-2-3, then Storm 4-5 with Reino Room and Emmanuel Gaxella, aka Godzilla. Then Reindu Muru has got Adrian McNaughton for company, actually, in 6th and 7th positions, as Reindu Muru going far off the track, somehow being able to keep things going. Oh, Martin Palm's behind Reindu Muru. Don't know what happened there. Did Palm bugger it up? Let me have a little look. Oh, yes, way off the track and hitting the barrier there, I think, did Martin Palm. Completely skips an entire corner, rejoins back behind Muru. That's a rare mistake there, I have to say, by Martin Palm, and that's going to cost him, because suddenly he's now 6 seconds off the lead, stuck behind Reinu Muru, and he's in a Storm Racing sandwich, and I think that may be a bit of a problem. And yeah, that car is looking a little bit worse for wear as they pass poor old Gravit's bonnet. Gravit has left the game, so I wonder if he'll be back again. So we've got all of that. Randy Muru, they're really struggling in sixth position with some of the old skidding around. Then behind McNaughton we've got Talbot in eighth. Ahab Abbas is in ninth. Barry Ward now down into tenth position. Ilja Brachalo back in 11th. Not quite the ascension up the order we hoped, but in 17 seconds off the lead. He's still reeling in people in front of him. John Gibbons has passed Paul Joseph, so he can get through that. George Talbot's back past Adrian McNaughton. McNaughton's very slow up the hill. What has he done to himself? Has he been busy self-harming? Because that car looks a little bit dodge as he comes over the hill. Ehab Abbas passes through. Gaxella's in trouble as well, because he's side by side with Palm for 4 and 5 as they come up over the hill. Is there going to be side by side when they get to the end of it though? Yes they are. Gaxella trying to hold him around the outside. That would be fantastic if he's able to do that around the outside. Indeed he does. Martin Palm suddenly goes from 3rd to 4 to 5. He's tumbling down the order faster than you can say fiddlesticks. And my goodness, Martin Palm, oh, fiddlesticks. Yeah, Martin Palm, not enjoying himself at all there. He's once again breaking late. We didn't see any of this in round 1. I don't know what he's doing. It's like he's suddenly seen red or something. Maybe he's been busy. Maybe he thought he was driving Fleming's Durex's car, and then his girlfriend seen red on a pregnancy test or something, because that's not going to plan at all. As he is now in fifth, Murray is still 2.5 seconds behind, so that won't be too far before he catches up if he continues like that. Further back down the field, Ehab Abbas is past Adrian McNaughton still, and that looks like Barry Ward's having a go for 9 and 10th. Barry Ward, never one to say no, is through. And that is great move there. He didn't even need to wait until he gets to the corner. Is he going to go for a Bass 2? No, he's just going to nudge the poor little bugger around the corner. So that's a little bit of argy-bargy, but it doesn't matter because they're all pointing in the right direction. Talbot is not far ahead. So 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, all in one fell swoop. 2.5 seconds just covering each other there. So Barry, that's not going to be good as well. That looks like Abbas is in trouble too. As look at that, Barry Ward, McNaughton, Brachalo, three wide down the straight. Absolute drama's going on there. As Martin Palm is past Reinu Muru, as is Gaxella actually. And McNaughton is off in 11th position. Somehow he's been able to break it on the grass, but that has dropped him to the back of that little train of cars. So let me just take a quick look at that, because I was busy watching Muru making a mistake and dropping from 3rd to 5th. And let's just take a look as they go into it. Yeah, it's Brachalo there giving McNaughton a bit of a nudge just in the braking zone. So poor old Adrian there just being pushed off the side. Not good at all there for poor old Adrian as he comes round the rest of the lap looking a little bit lost in 11th position. Brachalo versus Ward. Is Ilja having a look? No, he's not. They're all busy just locking each other up and having a little bit of a drama. But everything's going fine. Mike Ward versus Aid Randall for 16th and 17th position. Side by side round a corner. They shouldn't be side by side. Can Aid Randall do it round the outside? That'll be a classic move if he does that. Aid Randall for English Racing Lights Lords round the outside of Mike Ward in one of the fastest corners of the circuit. That is balls to the wall. Mike Ward's going to have a go back. And he's going to go back through. Aid Randall was so busy trying to get that position in one corner that he's left it wide for Ward to have a go back on the next one. Great stuff. 16th and 17th position only. Who cares when you've got racing like that going on? Lap 10 of 16. Tim Spur and Martin Jones. Oh, it's Brachalo's in the pits and he's overshot in 14th position. He's reversing back down the pit lane. I think you might get a black flag for that one, my friend, as Paul Huggett is in 2 from 19th. Please don't retire, my little huggable friend, because that will be a shame, because he's on for more points. as the Ward and Randall battle continues for 15-16, although Randall has now dropped a little bit behind that, so we'll leave that for now. Talbot, Abbas and Ward. Abbas is having a go at Talbot for 7, 8 and 9. Abbas is through, Ward is through. Talbot is going to be double whammied from 7 to 9 in one fell swoop. Poor old Georgie Porgy down the field. And look at Barry Ward, he's going to have the pair of them by the sounds of it. Is he going to do it? No, he's not. He's side by side contact between the two. Somehow they've both been able to keep it on the circuit. Oh my goodness. I tell you what, I've not seen cars like this where you can just keep it on the limit, go over it and still recover it. So that's just something to do with the track as well, because the track is quite heavily cambered in different places, but this has provided fantastic racing action. Not necessarily with massive loads of overtakes, just seeing everyone have to react to everyone else's mistakes and go absolutely nuts as they go through some of the more challenging and tighter, twistier circuits, corner formations rather. Lap 11, Barry Ward, that's not the racing line. Just about keeping it together, Abbas is going to have a sniff to roof through. That's Abbas four-wheel drifting through. Oh, dearie me, you're going to give me a coronary. This is nuts. As George back down to ninth again, as Barry Ward has a little yoink through. Adrian McNaughton's going to be catching this quite soon, as Barry Ward goes round the outside. Oh, and now he's off into the wall. Uh-oh. There was no help involved with that one. Watch out, Gibbons. Don't be a Gibbon on the Gibbon, because that won't help you with any of your fans. As he gets back in front of Paul Joseph, Tim Spur is going to go through too. Has that got a puncture, that car? Because it's smoking quite heavily, is Barry Ward, as he goes over the hill, somehow able to keep it all together. But I think he might have to peel off into the pit lane once again. Another fantastic piece of driving by Barry Ward, not going to be rewarded as they pass the remains of Mark Gravett. And no, he's not going to pit. Brave man Tim Spur fancying a nose straight through in the battle for 12th and 13th. Oh, off he goes. Not good at all. Ildra Bracalo is out of this race. He's crashed out unseen by us, so he's not good either. As Martina Sidnovas, our leader by 2.3 seconds, is in the wall, that's not helping either. So no one is giving themselves any help whatsoever. Paul Huggett's three laps down, he's going to move into 18th very shortly as he passes the stricken Bracalo. Everyone else still on the lead lap. Stuart Fleming doing a much better job this time by. Sidnovas leads from Spoliarik. Third has got Emmanuel Gaczela, and Martin Palm is all over the back of him with three laps left to go. Palm once again, I think he'll feel cheated if he's not back on the podium, but running in deep into that turn will not help him. Reinu Muru is in fifth, just keeping a watching brief 1.7 seconds behind Martin Palm as they continue on. Reinu Muru is sixth, he have a Bass is seven, Talbot eighth, Gibbons 9, is look at how close they are. And that's where you can see Abbas, I think, met his end there, because there's a bit of car left down at the bottom of that string. Talbot 8, McNaughton 9, Gibbons is 10, Joseph 11, Spur 12, Ward is 13th. He's dropped 4 seconds off of Tim Spur, so he must be really struggling with that puncture. Mark McNaughton, Mike Ward, Aid Randall, Stuart Fleming and Paul Huggett are your remaining cars. And that is definitely Martin Palm having a look through. He's going to push out to have a go. Gaczela has it covered. He's always got the inside line. I don't know if Gaczela is able to set up his car so that he can just attack the inside as they go flying over the hills. Across the line they go once again. I can't believe that they all take a little bit of the grass around that corner. I think that's very naughty. Yeah, but it's bit a few people on the backside. Basically Tom Ely in round one. Over the hill they come, 8 seconds off our leader Sidnovas, who once again has serenely wandered away up front while carnage has unfolded behind him. But Sidnovas is coming up to a bit of traffic now, so that could be problems for him. And in fact, it's Stuart Fleming who's busy spinning in front of Borna Spoliarik. Spoliarik able to keep away from the Durex sponsored man. I'm sure he's not really sponsored by him. There's Martin Palm not helping himself at all there with a power slide out from the curb. But as fancy as it looks, it's not getting him the laps time that he needs. And this is the last lap now that they're on to. So it's got to happen. Now or never. Sidnivus serenely up ahead, wandering through. No one else particularly. Well, George Talbot and McNaughton are side by side in 8th and 9th, but aside from that, it looks as though everyone else is sorted. So it's just a battle for 8th and 9th and a battle for 3rd and 4th, although Palm does look like he's slotted a little bit behind, 7 tenths down. And again, he's using grass in places that he shouldn't. So I don't think that will work at all. So, once again, it looks as though we've got a 1-2 for Torrent Motorsport. Oh, Martin Palm, they're off the track there, but over the hill comes Martina Sidnovas, once again looking quite nifty around these last couple of corners. He's driven another exceptional race, and this is 2 out of 2. Can he make it 3 out of 3? Martina Sidnovas crosses the line to win round 2 here at GRC at Seven Hills. Oh, something's going on further down the field. It's Ehab Abbas facing the wrong way in ninth position. We'll come back to that. Sidnovas wins. Spoliarik second. Gaxella third. Martin Palm is 4. Reino Muru is 5th. Randu Muru 6th, Adrian McNaughton is going to cross the line for 7 ahead of George Talbot, John Gibbons, Paul Joseph. Ehab Abbas got stuck on the curbs there, round into the hairpin, and has lost so many places. He must be so sick of himself because it's been such a disastrous evening of events so far for Ehab. McNaughton comes through 7, Talbot has got 8th. The unceremonial finish into the barriers down at turn 1. Gibbons grabs 9, Joseph 10, Abbas squeezes through on Tim Spur for 11th and 12th position. Fantastic action for them. Barry Ward, 13th position. 14th, Mark McNaughton, doing a wonderful job as ever. Mike Ward, unlapped in 15th position. I think he'll be pretty pleased with himself with that, to be fair. Going to be about 1 minute 14 down, but great run by him. 16th and only just lapped Aid Randall. 17th Stuart Fleming with a much better and more confident drive this time around for Team Core. I believe that now means that for the English Racing Knights, it's Paladins 1, Lords 1. So that'll be interesting to see how that ends up. Paul Huggett came home 18th, 3 laps adrift after a pit stop for PPR Rockstar. Cool, Huggy. And our retirements. There are only 4 crumbs. Ilja Bakalo, lap 9. Stackaroo into the barrier. Mark Gravett. Crasharoo into the barrier. Mark Jones. Smasharoo into the barrier. And Tommy Lee blew his engine. So, everyone is home and dry. So, poor old Ilja Bracalo moaning in the chat room that actually everyone's using his car as a bumper, which, to be fair, they are, mate. Sorry, not having a good night for it, but once again showing great pace, and you can't beat a bit of great pace. Unless, of course, someone's beating you. So for round 3, we've got the Finger of Fear. Oh, yes. The Finger of Fear goes onto the random number generator, and that number between, I think it's 5 and 10, it might be 5 or 8, will then reverse those positions of the grid. We may have to skip that idea due to technical difficulties. Nah, invalid my bum. Well, ooh. This is the problem of doing commentary in a chair that has wheels, because I've now managed to wheel over my microphone and now I'm just looking a little bit confused. Very special. Good job, I've got myself a strawberry and wheat grain yogurt. It says it's low fat, or fat free, so therefore it doesn't count. I've decided actually that just food in general that isn't eaten at mealtime doesn't really count. It's a myth. It does worry me the amount of people that want me to do a Legard. Sounds like a party piece that I would never want to wear. But thanks everyone for coming into the chat room, it does make it good fun. Got a couple of minutes left until the final session begins. Oh, is that what it is? And we're away! Yes, he was fired for a good reason. He talked to the TV people like we was in radio. But never mind. Yes. Ah, he's really going for it now. The best thing about Legard when he was in F1 was the disdain that Martin Brundle had for everything that he said. Because it was quite apparent that he really couldn't give two tosses. There's some good little quotes on Tube of the U Variety where you can hear Martin Brundle just not giving a toss. What on earth he says. So, just while we're filling the gaps up, while the grid is being sorted out, don't forget, if you are new to GRC, you can pop over to rfgrc.co.uk, where you can sign up on our league control. We've got plenty of other stuff apart from this Touring Car Championship going on. There's endurance stuff coming up soon. We're going to have... VLN Light Challenge. Oh my god! Is that what VLN stands? I've Veranstaltung Mein Schaft Lang Stricken Polkul Nürburgring. We'll call that Bob for short. Oh, five GTI, five cars on the toughest track on earth. Blah, blah, blah. Yeah, that has something going on Wednesday. You don't need a license to really go for that. You just need to sign up now. Go on, you know you want to. Great little forum, great community, great place for the race. Yes, there will be a full endurance stuff coming on. I'd like to take a moment to quickly plug something that both myself and Mr. Melhuish, our cameraman extraordinaire, is doing. And that's on the 30th and 31st of this month. Sorry, 31st and 1st of... Yeah, April Fool's, I wish it was. We're doing a 24-hour... Le Mans Mace, care of race department, and I will be there for the whole 24 hours. And if you thought there was only so much crap someone could talk, you've not heard that broadcast yet. So come on down, there'll be me, plenty of other fantastic people, lots of drivers, lots of team banter, and great fun. So hopefully that will all be sorted out. Okay, and the number for the inverted grid is numero 7. Woo-hoo-hoo. So that would mean the top seven will be reversed. So that will potentially mean Adrian McNaughton will be starting from pole position, Storm Racing team. Yes. Yeah, just popping into the chat, someone's chatting about, they've given us a website for everything to do with quotes of Ledyard and Brundle. I don't like the look of that website, I don't think that that's a real one. Well, no, if you, and Dan Long, if you are wanting to sign up, I'm sure there is something that a snail could do. The only problem is that you actually might have to stay on the tarmac, would be good. But no, lovely to see a nice little collection of cars, people in the chat room. Could all be in cars. I'll tell you, do you know what? It's because where I've had to, where I've done so many endurance race things, I'm just now tuned in to talking absolute tosh for hours on end. And now that I have to speak speeded up, it's all coming out like gibberish.
Right, the problem is fit.
I had... That was cameraman extraordinaire Simon Mehuish making a very rare entrance into the broadcasting airwaves there. But we should all be thankful for all the time and effort that he puts into these wonderful events. And currently he is dueling as admin and cameraman. So hats off to him. Oh yes. I think definitely he needs a little bit of a hatsy off. Mr. Mehuish is pretty awesome. And stuff, yeah.
Attention grid, will all non-essential personnel leave the grid now?
Ah, thank you, Kimmy, for that link. So, anything else exciting that I think that we should chat about before the race kicks underway? Yes! Don't forget, we're here next week as well, same time, same place. I think I've already went over this at the top of the broadcast, but next round, on Monday the 19th of March, and I'll be a whole 28 years old by then. We'll be at Poznan in Poland. I've not been on that track for ages. There may be a reason for that. We'll soon find out if it doesn't provide good action next week. But yeah, that's a much faster track if I remember rightly. Almost Grand Prix stuff. So, I didn't realise that we were out on formation lap. So, Adrian McNaughton, pole position then. Randu Muru will be alongside in the courtesy car. Third is Bruno Muru. Fourth, Martin Palm for Tyrant Motorsport IP Forge. Fifth, Emmanuel Gaczela. Sixth, Borna Spoljarek. Seventh, the man that's won them all so far but needs to come from seventh, not pole this time to do it, Martina Sidnovas. George Talbot, eighth. Oh god. Ninth, John Gibbons. Tenth, Paul Joseph for Union in Motorsport International. 11th, Ehab Abbas. I don't know where George is going. I think he's gone into the barriers on the outlap. That's suspiciously Coulthard-esque. 12th, Tim Spur. Barry Ward, 13th, once again midfield, hoping for a better result to end his evening. Mark McNaughton, 14th. Mike Ward, 15th. Paladins ahead of the English Racing Knights board to Wade Randall. 17th, Stuart Fleming, the team core. of the hard variety, I'd imagine. Paul Huggett, PPR Rockstar, 18th. Ilja Brachalo, 19th. When will it go right for the poor guy? And 20th on the grid will be Tom Ely. because the Agua Racing guys, I think, have given up for the evening, considering they've been in the barriers more often than not. So the third and final time of asking then today, we've got a race on our hands. But this time, the man who's been up front will certainly not be starting from there. The lights are on. We're racing here, and McNaughton's off to a tardy start by the looks of it. Look at Martin Palm. He's already passed into potentially third position, past Rainer Room. And is he going to have another go round him? Muru going off around the outside. There's contact between the two. Muru's off out into the outside, trying to go round McNaughton, but he's got nowhere else to go. He's going to be pushed off if he's not careful. Everyone just about squeezing through. Mike Ward so close to the ball. And Aid Randall there completely missed the start and is only just going around turn one now, so I don't know if he fell asleep or not. Adrian McNaughton, though, leads the way from Randy Muru, Martin Palm, Reino Muru, Martina Sidnova's up into fifth position. Someone's off the track. It's George Talbot in eighth position, somehow just about keeping himself in the action and out of the barriers, which is, to be fair, the name of the game. Don't know what's happened to Gazzella. They're down into seventh position. It looks about like he's going to go down the inside of someone. Ooh, past Spoljarić he goes. Side by side between the two. Spoljarić's got a much better exit because Gazzella had to take such a tight line in. Spoljarić keeps the position. So Gazzella down to seven. Martin Palm then up to third, though, having a right good go. Is Mirando Muru all over the back of Adrian McNaughton, who's kind of like a bottle top, keeping everyone stuck right behind him. This is going to cause absolute dramas up and down the field. Ilja Brachalo's off the track for, although he's into 11th position, so he's done not badly. Paul Joseph and Mike Ward have collected each other and both lost bumpers. So here comes Randy Muru, not quite able to do it this time by. Martin Palm keeping a watching brief, but there they go. Martin Palm's not keeping a watching brief much longer. He's fancying a right good nose. He bows through. I don't think there's going to be a gap there by the time they get to this fast corner, because overtaking around this bit is quite hard. Spoljarić there over the curbs, and he's going to run out wide on the outside, and Gazzella once again is going to go through as Muru is sideways once again in second position. You've got to have eyes like a little boggle as someone's off in the background. It's Stuart Fleming and Mark McNaughton have collected each other in 15th and 16th places. Both have rejoined the circuit as Martin Palm is threw up into second position past Randy Muru. That looks like Gazzella's in trouble, or is it Sidnovas? I'm not sure. They're all struggling to get round. Yeah, we've got an 8-car breakaway. Then there's a gap back to John Gibbons in 9. So 8 cars very much in it. And look at the way they're all flying their way through. Gazzella and Spoljarić hitting each other. George Talbot getting his nose in. That's always going to be a deadly problem for one of them. And it looks as though Spoljarić has been pummeled back down from 6th to position. That's not worked out well for Bulner at all. Sidnovas is now into 5th. They've got the Murus up against each other side by side into turn 2. Somehow everyone getting round. McNaughton still leads. Martin Palm is all over the back of him as those two have made us breakaway by a second from the Muru brothers. And oh, Gazzella, as that Sidnovas is off. Sidnovas is off. He's going to spin round. Is he going to collect everyone? No. Just about manages to keep it together, but down to 8th position, it's a little bit tougher when you're not up front, isn't it, Martinez? As the three of them go side by side, Spoljarić and Talbot so busy battling each other, Sidnovas is going to have the pair of them. He's not going to be smacked by Talbot, which he is, and he's being pushed around the corner. Talbot, what are you doing? It's like someone's given it, everyone's put a red flag on the back of him, and he's just kind of nose nudging people around the track. Not quite the clean racing that he would. It is a red flag to a bull. But no, they're not red cars, so he needs to sort that one out. Spoljarić is, but Sidnovas isn't. And Sidnovas, once again, off the track, all over the shot. Look at Tom Ely. Ely has got round Gibbons and is suddenly clawed onto the back. Tom Ely needing a good finish after what has been a fruitless night for him so far. That's someone off. That's Gazzella, is it? Oh, Spoljarić, sorry, was going in far too deep, and Sidnovas now fancying a nose through. They're bashing each other, Spoljarić onto the grass, they're flashing lights at each other. Stop flashing lights, they've smacked Tom Ely! Ely, who was minding his own business, they've just driven into him, trying to be busy bitching about each other. Apologies for my languidly jalousy. Oh, Barry Ward is out. Suspension failure, and that was down at turn one. He lost it all on his own, smacked into the barrier, as so many people have done. Barry Ward out from what has been an absolute disaster of an evening for him, despite some fantastic racing. Back up front, though, Palm is now ahead of McNaughton. He's taken the lead for Torrent Motorsports, and that happened at the beginning of the lap, by the looks of it. McNaughton now down to second, Reino Murray, then Randy Murray, Manuel Gaxella, George Talbot still ahead of Spoliarik. Sid Novus is now into 8th with Tom Ely 9, and Brocarlo suddenly finds himself in 10th position. And it's all kicking off right up the front. I think some people are getting a little bit too aggressive for their own good, and he's pulling across to defend, or is he letting Sid Novus through? I think he is letting Sid Novus through. A good move there by Spoliarik. Nice and gentlemanly. Stays ahead of Tom Ely. Brocarlo now back up with them all again. No one quite there yet to nerf him off the track. As they all continue on. Back up front in the battle for second, third, fourth and fifth. Gaxella. Oh, Muru's off! Randy Muru's in the wall! He's off. He lost it all on his own accord coming out of the first corner. Is he going to continue on? He's moving out of the way to let everyone through, or is he? He's kind of in the most annoying piece of the apex of the circuit where the cameras are all dodgy. He's back going in 10th position. So he's now down in 10th position. Still going though, as back up front, Brocarlo, Ely, Spoliarik and Sid Novus, they're all pushing each other around the corner. This is too aggressive and angry for its own good, and they're flashing lights at each other. I think someone's going to lose it soon and just go absolutely missile crazy, almost Talbot-esque, into the back of somebody as they continue to push each other around. Martin Palm leads by 1.6 seconds now from Reino Murru. Murru there. I pressed the off switch there. George Talbot smacking the barriers, round he goes. I was so excited I pressed the mute button. Whoops. Never mind. George Talbot, round he goes. And he's going to be off the track again. Yes he is, he's in the barriers, and that is the end of George Talbot's afternoon here, or evening here, from 12th position. Can't say I'm surprised. Disastrous end to the evening there for Georgie Pudge. Up to 13th goes Paul Joseph. Let's see who everyone else is out. I think, Stuart Fleming's... Stuart Fleming's up into 12th now for Team Core. He's doing a great stuff. Paul Joseph down to 13. Mike Ward is a lap down and is just letting everyone through. Huggett's still going. But yeah, Talbot, Mark Bucknaughton, Barry Ward are our retirements so far. So they're dropping a little bit like flies. Martin Palm now 1.8 clear of Reino Murru. Gaxella now pulling away from Adrian McNaughton, who suddenly found himself in fourth after an evening of great fun. Sid Novus now up to fifth position. Is ahead of Spoliarik, Tom Ely and Ilja Brocarlo. This is the best battle it looks like on Trek at the moment. Brocarlo looking the most feisty. Not quite sure where Bourne is going. Someone get that man a compass and get him back on the black stuff. Barry Ward in the chat room just saying that he was having very bad lag all evening. To be fair, mate, not a lot of it was your fault. You was just being bullied from side to side. So better luck for round two, mate, as look at the four of them just swinging their cars around the circuit. None of them is really staying on the racing line. Or on the black stuff. So, not good for them. What can I do in Alan? Yeah, I don't know quite how... I'm assuming this is one of those tracks that when you've been damaged, it affects you quite heavily, because cars do seem to be very much all over the shot, and I don't think very many cars will be... helpful there. Let's just see what else is going on. Aid Randall still going in 15th position. Paul Huggett still 16th. Mike Ward a lap down 17th. There's still 17 runners remaining. 1.5 seconds now the gap between Palm and Muru. It's constantly yo-yoing about. But look at Tom Ely and Brocalo for 7th and 8th positions. They're so busy battling each other, they're allowing Sidunovas and Spoliarik a little bit of breathing space, and if they allow that, there may be a gap that develops between them. Spoliarik could do well to put a gap between himself and the barrier at the exit of that hairpin, because he keeps smacking it a little bit every time. That can't really be helping him at all. Brocalo fancying half a look. Not going to happen. And if anything, that's actually misplaced Brocalo on the racing line. And that's brought it to an ignominious end, that battle, for the time being. See there, Randy Murray, just a little bit of a blip in the background. Gone but not forgotten. Adrian McNaughton has been reeled in by Sidunovas and Spoliarik. So it will be interesting, because none of those lot know the word break. Yeah, or give way, or manners, or etiquette. Mind you, Sidunovas there running out quite wide. I don't think Spoliarik will need any of those, because he'll blast through down the straightway. Indeed he does, Spoliarik, up into fifth position. Yoink, he says. Is he going to have a go at McNaughton round the outside? That'll be a brave man with big hairy ones if he does, but nope. Not needing to do so, but Sidunovas straight into the slipstream. I think he's going to fancy a nose through. They're practically nudging each other through some of these corners. It's so close. And is Spoliarik's going to have a go down a smack between the pair of them. McNaughton is barged off the road. Sidunovas goes through as well into fifth position. Proper slinky snake style. And I think Tom Ely is now going to have a go for the Nocturne team. And is he going to go through to turn one? God damn, between the two, that was inevitable. Tom Ely goes flying off the track, holds himself onto the brakes. He knows what happens. He's going to come straight in front of everyone. What on earth was that? He'd done all the right things to try and keep himself out from crashing into other cars, and then rejoins right thick in the middle of it. Oh, never mind. We will have little brain fade moments. It's all very well me shouting it in the commentary booth. I'm not the one out there screaming around in my car. Tom Ely now looks like he's going to bin it into the wall. Now he keeps himself out of it. Oh, is that Stuart Fleming facing the wrong way there in 17th position? And I think that's a car that... Oh, no, he's got back going again. But I tell you what, if that car lives up to its name, I wouldn't use it in any way, shape or form, because it's blown its top. And I don't think that would be used in any safe mannerism of anything of any kind. McNaughton's off. Ninth position. Is that the wheel missing? No, he's going now down to 10th now. He goes as he slips down. Through goes John Gibbons. Paul Joseph is another 8 seconds behind. Is he going to keep going? No, he retires. Adrian McNaughton out of the race for Storm Racing. That's a shame, because he'd got himself all the way up to fourth position in what had been a trying evening of entertainment for him. Lap 10 of 16 completed for our leaders now as they cross the line. Ely now up to 7, Muru up to 8, Spur to 9, Gibbons to 10. Joseph and Gaxella and Muru side by side. Gaxella is up into second position. Muru having a tardy exit. I think that was a let through. I think team orders at play. Someone else has just swapped positions. That's not good. How very Alonso-ish of you as they continue up the field. Yeah.
Emmanuel is faster than you.
I can't do that accent at all. That accent is ingrained in my head through lots of playing of F1 2010. Worst ever pit crew voice. Do you know, he's really nice when you see him on the radio on F1, but not when you've had him screaming in your ear about how rubbish you are for 78 laps of Monaco. Only slightly angry. Yeah. Paul Huggett now up to an unheard of 14th position. Corker of a race there for Paul Huggett. Yeah, let's give some huggy some loving, because I don't think people appreciate the fact. Oh dear, Sidunovas is round and round and round, and he's down. Ilja Brocalo goes up into fifth position. Huggett there back going again, but Sidunovas just rejoining not too far ahead of Tom Ely. Oh dearie me, Mr. Huggy. not really his fault. It's so difficult to pass people around here as Tommy Lee flies through. It's nuts. John Gibbons off the track in 12th position, just dragging through the gravel to rejoin again. Lost it down into turn one, and that's put him out from what was 10th position. So he have a Bass then up into 10, Joseph to 11, Gibbons down to 12, Aid Randall now 13, Puckett 14th, Ward 15, Stuart Fleming still going in what is 16th position once he gets round the stricken Adrian McNaughton at the end of the lap, but that car is looking so worse for wear. I'd be surprised if it makes it home. Martin Palm, four laps to go, including the one that he is on. 2.4 seconds now clear of Emmanuel Gaxella. Third, Rainum Room. Room. Just mixing up all these drivers' names. Never mind. I should be like some in-house breeder, but Borna Spoljarić reeling him in at a rate of knots. Reino Muru's last lap was a 1:15. He'd done a 1:19 before that, that's why. Whereas Borna Spoljarić is in the 14.2s, so that is why he's reeling him in at over a second a lap. Spoljarić, straight onto the back of him, he's dragging Brecalo with him, and Sid Novus, as we know his speed is there, is only a further second behind him, so everyone still all to play for, as Borna there nearly smacking the back of Maru, much to the scariness of my cameraman extraordinaire Simon Melhuish, who is also TMO boss. And you don't want to upset the boss live on air, Borna. You've done it before, but I don't think you should do it now. As look at the sliding action that he gets coming out of the final corner. He's going to be through halfway down this straight. Flies past Reino Muru, who's, I think, going to know not to come back at him. Nope, Borna's got the position. Oh, he's onto the grass, though. Just about keeps it all together through into third position. Ilja Brecalo next up on the list, as Reino Muru is starting to be slightly battered down the field. Everyone else pretty much spread out. There's a couple of people within a couple of seconds of each other, but that's about it at the moment, as here comes Brecalo nerfing nearly the car round. There is a change of position. It's Ehab Abbas is off the track, and with a puncture in 11th position, his car, I don't know if he'll know if he'll make it round to the pits, actually, to be fair. It's absolutely steaming of a puncture, and well, yeah, it does indeed. As he's driving around on the grass, I don't know if he's looking like he's going to try and make it back, because there's still good a fistful of points to be won with 11th position. And even if he just goes to the pits and repairs and comes back out, he's still going to grab lots of points because he's in so many retirements. Reino Muru still holding on to 4th position, dropped a whole 1.5 seconds behind Spoljarić that lap. So the difference in speed is clear to have, although Borna making a complete hash of that turn just in front of them. Brecalo straight onto the back. It's this lap and one after that he's got left. Palms 1.7 clear still of Gaxella. It's closing down, but I don't think it's going to close quickly enough, as Brecalo nearly giving Muru a helping hand over the corner. Not helping at all, that. Yeah, all of these new paint designs, and everyone's busy trashing them. So a good job this isn't for real, otherwise I think a lot of teams wouldn't make it through the rest of the season on their budgets. So Martin Palm makes his way round the final couple of corners to start his final lap. The gap's just going to dip under 1.5 seconds, but I think Palm's got that one managed as he crosses the line where 1.3 is now. Abbas in the pits, already dropped to 12th. Aid Randall's up to 11, so that's a great result for Aid if he can hold that one together. Gaxella 1.3 behind Palm. I don't think he's going to catch him. Spoljarić, Reino, Randu Muru out very wide. Brecalo's going to put him in side by side. That's not a place to go side by side, and they're bashing between a pair, and Brecalo is through up into fourth position. What is Muru going to do in response? He's got to look in his mirrors as well, because Sid Novus is right behind too, as the three of them fly over the